Hi, my name is Michele, Scientific Content Manager at Izon Science. In this video, I will be covering the basics of lipid nanoparticles, or LNPs, which are of great interest across the field of nanomedicine. This is down to their ability to protect and deliver a wide range of therapeutics, and their potential for targeted delivery. LNPs have been around for decades in various forms, and were propelled into the spotlight more recently with the development of COVID-19 vaccines. There are many fascinating applications of LNPs, which will be covered in a separate video. But for now, I will just highlight the basic structure of the three most common types. The first and most simple particle type is the liposome, which, as I will explain shortly, actually lives in a bit of a grey area. Some people consider liposomes to be the first generation of lipid nanoparticles, and to be fair, a number of liposomal formulations have been approved. They were first described in the 1960s, where negative staining of phospholipids and electron microscopy were used to reveal their structure. Liposomes are spherical vesicles consisting of one or more lipid bilayers surrounding an aqueous core. Bioactive compounds may be contained either within the hydrophilic core or in the hydrophobic bilayer, and this positioning depends on the properties of the bioactive compound itself. Formulations can include the use of synthetic and naturally occurring phospholipids, as well as surfactants. Liposomes can come in many sizes, but typically fall between 70 to 2,500 nanometers. A different and more modern particle type is the solid lipid nanoparticle. Solid lipid nanoparticles were developed 3 decades after liposomes and offer an improved cargo release profile. They are comprised of a solid lipid core with a surfactant shell, and the active ingredient is contained within the core. The lipids in the core are solid at room temperature and can make up between 0.1 to 20% of the particle, with the rest being in aqueous phase and surfactants for stability. Solid lipid nanoparticles tend to be slightly smaller than liposomes, usually falling in the range of around 40 to 1,000 nanometers in diameter. Often, solid lipid nanoparticles intended for therapeutics are around 100 nanometers in diameter, and their size is impacted by the choice of lipid and surfactant. Solid lipid nanoparticles are defined by their solid lipid core. As liposomes don't have that feature, many don't actually consider liposomes to be true lipid nanoparticles. Next up are particles that are referred to as second generation LNPs. They are nanostructured lipid carriers, which were developed to overcome some of the limitations of solid lipid nanoparticles. Some of their proposed benefits include a greater loading capacity for some drugs, better control of drug targeting and release, and enhanced physical stability. Nanostructured lipid carriers are comprised of both solid and liquid phase lipids. Here, bioactive compounds can be within a solid or liquid phase, the interface between solid and liquid, or even all three. The size range of nanostructured lipid carriers is around 40 to 1,000 nanometers, but again, the smaller size range is preferred for therapeutics. In summary, the formulation of lipid nanoparticle-based delivery systems has evolved over many decades. From a foundation of liposomes to solid lipid nanoparticles and nanostructured lipid carriers, the future of nanomedicine is bright. Without these intricate delivery vehicles that protect fragile molecules, drug and vaccine development would not be where it is today.